The market regulator has allowed Category 3 alternate investment funds to participate in the commodity derivative space. So what does that mean for this sector? In fact, Mrugank Paranjpe, MD of MCX, has joined us on the phone line. And Manisha Gupta is also here to take us through that interview. Over to you, Manisha.
Well, thank you so much for that. It only is logical that decision to get in the institutional play, especially after SEBI has allowed options to be traded in commodity derivative markets in the previous week itself. So what would this do is that it will get the much-needed depth and liquidity into the markets, the price discovery, the price risk management, all of that actually comes into the markets. And while, of course, the SEBI chairman also talked about the mutual funds under consideration as well to be allowed in commodity markets, he, of course, did not give us a timeline there. But Mrugank, thank you so much for joining us. What is your first reaction? The markets, of course, were expecting this, but what would this mean for the commodity markets going forward?
So, Manisha, I think this was a most welcome and awaited decision. We had seen SEBI sort of follow a trend. So there is a white paper, there are comments which come in, and almost pretty much immediately after that, it goes to the SEBI board. So with that process having been followed for AIFs, we were all hopeful that it would happen now. It has happened. We are very happy. But I think what this really does is puts us on that big path towards getting all institutions in, because this is the first one. And like the SEBI chairman told us, we should soon be seeing something on mutual funds. Let's not want to hazard a timeline, but I think what's very important is institutions are finally in, and that's a big step. I think in the longer term, the last 2 weeks sort of heralds two path-breaking things for our markets, options being allowed, and now institutions being allowed, two reforms which we were all hopeful and wanted from SEBI once the markets were integrated. And I think we are on that way now in terms of taking this market forward.
Mrugank, also come in on the fact that after the institutional players do come into this space, we perhaps would be looking at diverse, complex trading strategies coming in as well. How ready are the markets? What's your sense in sense of participation and volumes going higher now for the exchanges?
So Manisha, one, institutional participation at depth, it adds liquidity. Most importantly, it also stimulates a whole host of things, including getting better research, including better tools, and having more participants come in. So I think that's what we are looking forward to. Also, in terms of risk management, again, all of us have been readying for creating our own clearing corporations. This will hasten that whole process, and we will create clearing corporations much faster than even what we had envisaged before. So I think what we will look forward to is completing some of these reforms, but as well getting much more liquidity and better products into the marketplace.
Mrugank, since you are with us, what's your sense on the options as well? Since that has been cleared, how soon do you see a launching one to start with?
So Manisha, I think we had spoken on the day this came in. We had sort of made a guess that it would be a 45-day timeline from then. We still stick to that timeline. We think it's just been a week since that announcement came. So the 45 days is somewhere going to be the end of July, beginning August, when we will actually start trading is what we think will happen.
One quick final question, Mrugank, and this one is on the mutual funds. That's also under consideration, as the chairman said and as you mentioned as well. How ready are the markets for this back-to-back reforms? We have been waiting for them for a decade, of course, but is the market now ready or is the pace too fast?
I think the pace is right because, as you know, a lot of these reforms are based on market feedback. So the AIF paper was in public domain, and at least our belief is that maybe more than 15-20 AIFs responded to that particular white paper. We believe it's exactly the same situation in the mutual fund space. We interacted with mutual funds. We had a roundtable sort of discussion with SEBI. We understand at least 10 to 12 mutual funds have expressed a keen interest and have worked towards the paper which should soon be coming to SEBI. So I think market is ready, market has an interest, and that's why we are seeing all these reforms come in.
Absolutely. And we will, of course, wait for the reaction out as well and the trading participation and volumes going up post that. Mrugank, thank you so much for joining us and giving us that breakdown.